Welcome, welcome, welcome to Sunday School on the Go. This is your host. Lord, I just thank you for this day. We thank you for these wonderful ministers on the roster that are in-house, ready to learn more and more and speak more and more about God's word. And so we're going to start it out. We're going to have Shanana to pray us in. Then we're going to have praise and worship, and then I'll be back.
Dear Heavenly Father, I want to thank you for bringing us together once again in your loving and kindness and graceful way. God, I pray you bless the teacher and everybody that's in the group. God, also, I pray that you will give the people that have lost loved ones or are in the process of losing those the strength that they need to carry on. God, also, I pray that you will bless us to be a blessing to others, for they know, but in our walk. I talk when we see someone just to say hello, because everybody is going through something. God, I pray that you will continually keep us in our right mind, renew our heart, renew our spirit, renew us every day in any way that you see possible. I know you already went before us in any situation, and I pray you continue to pour the blood of Jesus all over us. Lord, I thank you for being so wonderful. I thank you for everything you've already done, and in your son's name, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Who of us once already claimed victory in Christ, victory in the Lord, victory. I'm going to do a little mix here, somewhat of a mix. I'm going to start off with one of those O's. I remember when church used to start. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. Guess what I did? Guess what I did? I told Satan, get thee behind. Victory today is mine. Okay. That's the only piece I'm going to give there. I'm going to place up the depths. Still about victory in the Lord. Amen.
I got that. That was crazy. Got Yo, what you think?
Got you, one, brother.
Can I take it?
Come on, man.
I got that.
You call it.
I'm not.
Tell me all tomorrow. All right.
Sorry, guys. I'm sitting on my. I got no reason to fear. I got Jesus on my side. I got that.
Hey.
Jesus. Everybody's asking, why you always laugh when there is no reason to smile? And everybody say,
oh, yeah.
Why do you keep praying? Things ain't changed for you in quite a while. I think the karma stuff I had to go through just so I could be here today.
My Lord.
Just tell them my God won. Yeah. Hey.
Jesus on my side. Jesus on my, I got that. I got no reason to fear. I got Jesus on my, I got that.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. How many of you got that? Jesus
hey,
on your
I
side.
Got it.
Victory, yes.
Yes, victory. Amen.
Amazing, amazing, amazing. That's awesome. That's one of obviously one of my favorite songs.
Mine too.
I just love it because he breaks down, he tells you, you know, he ain't got it on his own. He got it because of Jesus. Amen. 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 We're gonna try our level best. Glory to God. We're going to try our level best to try to get through these gifts. I don't know what is taking so long. I do not understand it. I mean, I really do understand it, but it's like as soon as I say, okay, this is the last one. No. And so we're still in 1 Corinthians. We're in 1 Corinthians. I'm going to let y'all get there. Hold on. I need to get there a little late. 1 Corinthians. We're in 12. 1 Corinthians 12 chapter, and we're going to read verses 25 through 31. So this is like a couple of verses a piece. Everybody read two verses. Try your best to read two verses. I don't even know. It's only 6 verses in there.
See, you forgot to tell us what day it is.
Oh, I'm not done. I'm not done. I'm trying to give y'all a chance to get to the scripture. But today,
1 Corinthians
12, and we're going to be reading the last 25 through 31. We might even go to the end. What's the end of that?
31.
31 is the last verse?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Sorry. All right. So, since Miss Shanana reminded me, I know she's going to come up with number 23. Right? So.
Oh, yeah.
So number 7 is the number of completion. And the number 30 is actually the dedication of rulership. So in other words, it's about dedicating your leadership to the Lord. Dedicating your leadership to the Lord. And then number 23, Shanana.
God is with us.
God is with us. So as we begin to talk about finishing off the spiritual gifts today, that is in 1 Corinthians 12 chapter. But I just want to say today is an amazing day. Today is a day. It is a gift. It is a present that God has given us today. And not only do I want to talk about that, but I want to tell you what God is doing in the atmosphere. God is doing some things in the atmosphere. So this is going to lead into our prophecy for today. So I want to share with you, God has been sharing some things with me about what's going on in the atmosphere. And it's not what you think. It is not what it looks like. It is not what it looks like. We see turmoil. We see war. We see power struggles. We see all of those things that are going on in the atmosphere. But God told me to tell you this morning that everything that you give unto God, he will take care of it. Whatever it is, whatever you leave at the altar before him, he will take care of it. whatever you lay at his feet, he will take care of it. No matter what you're looking at, no matter what your situation is, he will take care of it. If it's finances, he will take care of it. If it's your health, he will take care of it. If it's your family, he will take care of it. No matter what it is, whatever that struggle is, whatever that obstacle in your way, God said, today, I will take care of it. He said that he is a God that never, he hasn't lied to you yet, so he ain't gonna start now. He is also the God that his ways are higher than our ways. His thoughts are higher than our thoughts. And sometimes we get caught up and we get bound up in what's going on right now. We get bound up in what the situation looks like. But I am here to tell you today that God got your back, that God is going to take care of it. Whatever it is, he told me to tell you, he's going to take care of it. As I begin, I got to slow down. Just let me calm down for just a moment, because the things we're going to be talking about today probably got me excited. But I heard God say in the spirit, oh, glory to God. I heard God say in the spirit that there's some mending that's going to take place. Some relationships, some mending in your heart, or some relationships that have been broken down, they will be mended within the next few months. So you will see a change in some things, some change in some people. And it's not going to be anything that you do. It is all because God wants to restore some things in your life. Okay, wait, I got to calm down. God told me to remind you also. I just hear it in the spirit. He told me to remind you also that anything he removes from your life, he does not need it to take you to the next level. Somebody say amen. Anything that he removes out of your life, he does not need it to take you to the next level. He also told me to stop mourning about your losses. And what I mean by that, I'm not talking about family members. There's some things, some situations, some jobs, some finances, some connections that you lost and you've been mourning about them. God says stop mourning about those things because they are not going to be needed at your next level. If you think about the children of Israel, when they began to go over into the promised land, Moses was able to look over into the promised land, but he couldn't go over. There were some things in his life that he was not allowed to cross over. And even when it came to David, I'm just saying, when David was wanting to build a temple, he had it in his heart because he was a man after God's own heart. But God told him, you can't do it. You got too much blood on your hands. And I know that God is a forgiving God, but God lets us know that certain things are in the past. They gonna stay over there. There are certain things that cannot go into the future with us. And so we must understand this and give it to God. It is hard sometimes when somebody's been walking with you and they've been doing things for you. Some of them been hindering you even, but sometimes we get caught up in the hindrance. We get caught up in making sure that we're helping somebody else. But God said, anything I remove from you is not going to help you in your next level. Woo. Woo. I got to calm down, y'all. We still got Sunday school to finish. Woo.
Amen.
We still got, I'm going to try my best to make it. But as I began to spend a little bit of time with God this morning, God just reminded me because I have some of the things that we're going to talk about today. I have some things in my life, some situations that are going on. And sometimes I do it to my own self. Things that I should have already cut off. Some things that I should have already let go. I keep on holding on to that thing. But God told me this morning, let it go. God told me this morning, whatever I took from you, it does not go into the next level with you. You don't need it. Anything that's removed, you don't need it. I have to calm down.
Go on, girl. Go on.
I don't know. I'm really trying to calm down. But as he began to minister to me, he began to show me some things about everyone on this call. Some things I can share. That's the main thing that I can share. But some of the things I can't. Some of the things is for me to pray. To pray that God manifests himself. To pray that God manifests himself in that situation. And in that circumstances. And God, and I'm telling you, I am not a prosperity preacher. And those on the call that have known me for a while, y'all know I'm telling the truth. Every now and then, God will let me know, hey, we're gonna get blessed. He already, because that's not my call. My call is to teach and to share the word of God, to teach even ministers, minister to the minister, God said. But anyway, let me calm down just a little bit. But there's some situations, there's some things that's getting ready to break for you in your life. There's some things that are getting ready to break. I mean, literally, you're going to be like, wow. And it's some things that you've been holding on to that God is going to remove. And you ain't even going to, it's going to be removed so easily, you're not even going to remember it, that it has been removed. Because when it's gone, later on down the line, you're going to be like, oh, I remember that. That situation, that thing that was holding me, is gone. And I didn't even remember it. I'm just saying, God getting ready to, because the reason why we're stuck on spiritual gifts is because not only are they already manifested in the group that's sitting here, but they are going to be increased. And what I mean by that is that you're going to see the working power of God. This is not about me. This is not about, this is all about God. And whatever God is getting ready to do in your life, he needs some things broken. He needs you to begin to let some things go. All those baggages that we had, that we carry. I'm one of them. I'm here. I'm not trying to tell you anything. I'm one of them because I hold on to stuff a lot. And so God is saying that there's some things that I've got to break them off of you because I need you to move forward in me. And I don't want anything to hinder you going forward. And I'm not saying no weapon formed against me shall be able to prosper. So in other words, what I'm not saying is that it's not going to be a reminder to you that it did happen, but it's not going to hinder you from going forward in his life and what he wants you to do. Okay. Prophecy of the day. That's it. Word of wisdom, word of knowledge, whichever way you want to call it. Breaking. I just hear breaking. I'm finna break it. Okay. Whew. Hold on. Just let me. Glory. Glory to God. Glory to God. I wish I could just show you that is not even on the paper. I write everything down. Y'all, I do my lesson. I study for y'all. I study for us. He just told me to put today's prophecy. There's nothing in here. That came straight from heaven. Came from the throne. Straight from God. Didn't have anything to do with me. And I'm glad we was able to record today. Yes. I'm going to go back and listen to it, see what he said for me too. Amen. Amen.
God is good too. God is good.
So, woo. Yes. Okay, I'm just give me just a moment to calm down. It's not going to take anything away. I just need to calm down just a moment so that we can at least get to these scriptures and talk about we're not going to get to talk about all of them again. These scriptures we're going to read today, we're going to read them again next week, and maybe I'll add a couple to it to finish off these spiritual gifts, because God said he was showing me some, okay, calm down. He was showing me some things. See, I said this over the periods of times that we've been talking about the spiritual gifts. If God did it back then, if we needed it back then, we need it today. And some of the things that we're going to be talking about today is proof of that. It's proof of that, that there is nothing new under the sun. There is nothing new under the sun. And the reason why I'm saying that is sometimes things change. It's a change, a transformation. But the base, the purpose, the foundation of everything that God has for us doesn't change. It doesn't change. Okay. Let me calm down. It's hard, y'all. I'm feeling, and I don't know if I'm going to be able to calm totally down, but we're going to try to get started. But because I feel his spirit just like resting heavily on me. If you could see this room right now, it's like a haze in here. It's like a like smoke-filled room. If I can't explain no how easier than that. It's like the room is filled with smoke. I can't really. The Bible talks about his train filled the temple, and nobody was able to do anything. They weren't even able to preach. His train filled the people. And see, people always talk about the Old Testament is not what we need. We need to stick with. I've heard people say that it's all in the new. No. His train filled the temple. That was in the Old Testament. Mm. That meant his spirit. Okay, calm down. I wish I could just push this with y'all, push this to y'all, throw it out there to you, just give it to you so you could just feel it. Okay, all right.
We feel it? Well, I feel it. Amen. Amen. All right. Speak for everybody.
So, I feel it too. Take your time.
See, God knows exactly what we need when we need it. So,
yes. When are we?
I can't. Oh.
What's the word I'm going to use? Oh. It's time. It's time. I mean, I sit up and say, we're children of God. We are God's children. He has work for us to do. All this stuff that we allow ourselves to be held up by what's happening within this world and circumstances. And sometimes it's people that's keeping us from where he wants us to be. He's a lie. Devil is a lie. He's going to always put something in us to distract us and keep us from where God wants us to go and where he wants us to be. So, man. Just staying prayed up and staying in his word. God's going to get us where he wants us to be regardless. The devil can try to hold us back for a little bit or to make us take a detour for a moment, but he's a lie. He's not going to win. With the Lord, we're winning. Amen. With God, we're winning.
Amen. Amen. Woo. Woo. Okay. So let's try to read the scriptures as I try to calm down so I can share what God gave me, because it's just as important as this message this morning. So I don't know how far we're going to get. I'm just telling you now, because that's really not important. What's important is God's move. So we're reading 1 Corinthians 12. And 2, 4, 6. There's only 6 verses. So if we want to read one verse a piece and maybe somebody read the last two, we can go that route. If what do y'all think? What do y'all want to do? Because we're going to read it again next week.
I mean, somebody reads one a piece. Is that what you're saying?
That's what I said. Go for it. We're gonna start with Brother Vinoy. We'll let the Montgomerys do the last two.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. You all hear me?
Now, yes.
Okay. That there should be no schism in the body, but that the members should have the same care one for another.
Richard.
And whether one member suffer, all the members suffer with it, or one member be honored, all the members rejoice with it.
Shanana.
What verse we on, sis? You lost me when we was praising.
27. If I'm not mistaken. Am I right?
Now you are the body of Christ, and each one of you is a part of it.
All right, Montgomery, y'all close it out.
This is NIV version. And God has placed in the church first of all apostles, second prophets, third teachers, then miracles, then gifts of healing, of helping, of guidance, and of different kinds of tongues. Are all apostles, are all prophets, are all teachers? Do all work miracles?
Do all have gifts of healing? Do all speak with tongues? Do all interpret? But honestly desire the best gifts, and yet I show you a more excellent way. Amen.
All right. Glory to God. I don't know what we're going to do. I got a lesson plan here, but still, I'm hearing stuff. So, we're going to start with, okay, so we already talked about apostles. We already talked about prophets, and we talked about teachers. That was the last few lessons that we've had. So today we're going to talk about, we're going to try to get to miracles. We're going to start with miracles. These are the three that I'm going to try to get to. The gifts of healing, miracles, and helps. We will see. We'll see how God, and then next Sunday, we're going to do the other three, which is administrations and the varieties of tongues. I can't remember how it says, speaking in tongues and interpreting tongues. So we're going to do all of that the next time. So let's look at miracles. So the first question I have is, what is the definition you believe of a miracle? Tell me what you think of it.
That's fairly easy. I go, anything that, you know, simply put, that defies the law of physics.
Okay.
It's that simple. Anything yep. that, yeah.
That's good.
I'll give an example.
Okay.
When I got pushed out in front of that vehicle and it was going 65 miles per hour and the Holy Ghost pulled me back, that's a miracle.
Amen. That's definitely a miracle. So as we begin to talk about miracles, anybody else? I see Brother Gary reached up. Was you going to say something?
No, I'm just old and I'm trying to get these kinks out of my back.
My old. Lord help us, Jesus. Methuselah was old. Okay, let's stop talking about that. We're not honest now. Okay. All right. So miracles. Okay, so a miracle is events, signs, wonders, experiences that demonstrates God's greatness and power. It is a work. It's worked by the divine power of God. Sometimes he utilizes people. It is actually, there's two words for it. One is dunamis, which is the mighty power of God, a force. It's a supernatural power. And the other word is mafoth, which is Hebrew for signs and wonders. And so as we begin to talk about miracles, one of the first miracles we're going to talk about, we're going to use the Bible because we know people get crazy, but we know that miracles are happening today. And I'm going to share one of my miracles that I had. So when you look at the Old Testament, we know creation, that was a miracle. The flood, when it had never rained before. I always put that in there because people be like, it rains all the time. Didn't back then. When the flood came, that was the first time it had ever rained on earth. That was the first time. When God appeared to the children of Israel in a pillar of cloud and fire. The parting of the Red Sea. We all know these things, right? You know the old Baptist song, bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Talk about manna from heaven. And we know they also sent quails, but you know, most people don't think of quails as being a miracle because birds are flying in the sky, but it is as well. Remember the Tower of Babel, when he confused the tongues, that was definitely a miracle. Even the fact that Moses was saved to help save the people, that was a miracle because they were people been dead. There are many miracles in the Old Testament, and we don't always talk about them. Miracles are not to bring glory to people. They have always been set up to bring glory and attention to God. We know about all the miracles that Jesus performed. Jesus did, he healed a blind man, he healed a sick man, he healed the palsy, he healed a person that couldn't walk. He did, before even Jesus, well, let's go back even further than that. We know that Mary, you know, having a baby when she had never been with anybody. That's the first miracle right there in the New Testament. When Jesus told them to go get the taxes and the fish had money in their mouth. Now, how many of y'all been fishing and you came out with some dough? Anybody? Anybody been fishing? And there's money in the mouth for the fish. Nobody? These are miracles. He healed the dumb, the deaf. He raised people from the dead. The widow's son, widow of Nan's son. He calmed the storm. And the main one that a lot of people talk about, besides feeding the 5,000, we know all of those are miracles as well, is when Peter walked on water. What was so miraculous about that? What was so miraculous about that is, first of all, I've never walked on water. Has anybody here?